sewn it in. But I did find that if I want to put them back together, all I have to do is just leave them over the other end first, get a little blame, and go back to where we started. Oh, I'm sorry, that's not showing. Now, the only way I found I could prevent the ends from falling off is by just tying them in a double knot like this. This prevents the ends from falling off. But this still leaves the rope very weak. In fact, it's so weak, you can even cut it with your own fingers. So you lift with two pieces, and they're not even cut the same length. So if I ever find that this happens, all I have to do is just take the end, put them over one and the other like this, and we will go back to where we started, right? There, oh, yeah. You don't have to cut, you don't have to cut. Just throw them away. Okay, I'm not kidding. I'll do this again, but I'll do it one by one. What's the end here? I just squeeze my fist, it goes into my hand. I mimic the action, throw me in the air, and it goes from one side to the other. I'll do it again, just with a squeeze of the fist. Throw it up, go back, and the end just jumps over to one side. Now, I want to get a few people examine a piece of rope. I'm going to get, who wants to examine this piece of rope? We're going to get a few volunteers. Yes, I see. What's your name? Kabuki. Am I saying that right? Yeah, perfect. Kabuki, I have a couple of pieces of rope. I'm going to get you to examine this piece of rope. Sorry. Make sure it doesn't stretch your string, it's just a normal piece of rope. Yeah. Now, I did mention that rope was pretty weak, but this rope is even weaker. In fact, it's so weak that you can even take a little piece off with your fingertips. I know that someone else is getting this piece of rope. Anyway, you can be volunteer, you don't have to get up, I can come to you. Anyone will get... Well, I'll tell you what, I'll pick someone myself, since no one is willing to do it. Yeah, we got one person here. Alright, we're going to examine this piece of rope. Go on, make sure it doesn't stretch your string.
Just real?
Yeah, it's a real piece of rope. I did mention that this rope was the weaker one, because even if I had to squeeze that rope down, it almost looks like the knot is gone. It is gone, it's still there. Just give it a shake, it goes back on. Yeah. I'll let one last person examine this piece of rope. Anyone?
I'll throw it to you.
Catch! I should have warned you this. Boy, make sure it doesn't stretch your finger, it's a normal piece of rope. Who has the best piece of rope? It's you. Could you please throw it to me? Are you ready yet? On three. Thank you anyway, good throw. You're more than keen. So this is the long piece of rope that we have. We have three pieces of rope, they're all different lengths. This is the longest piece. This is the longest piece, it's about 6 feet in length, also the same height as me. Yeah. Now, who has the medium piece? Yes. Perfect. What's your name?
Howard.
That's me, Howard. You know, Howard's actually the name of my girlfriend, my third girlfriend. I only have two. I've only ever had two. That was so lame. Howard, could you please bundle it up and bundle up and just throw the piece of rope to me. Yeah, just in a bit of a bundle like that. Throw it to me on three.
Sorry.
It's okay. My fault, I beat you. Kidding. So this is the medium piece of rope. We have one long piece and one medium piece, and this is about 3 feet in length, also the same length as my leg. And the last piece, who has the small piece? Who has the small piece? Right here. Thank you. That's funny, I didn't ask you to give it back. That's right. Now, you want to do it again?
Yes, please.
Okay, throw it to me. You ready? On three! I'm just joking you around.
Thanks very much, man.
Yeah, give him a round of applause. Thanks. And this is the last piece, the smallest piece, which is 6 inches in length, which is also the same length as my foot.
I don't know what you were thinking, it wasn't that, I guarantee. So we got three pieces of rope, all different sizes. You guys examined it. And you, all three of you, examined the piece of rope. Was there anything funny? It was nothing wrong. Yep. So we have three pieces of rope, one long piece, one medium piece, and one small piece. But I don't like them when they're all different lengths. So, if I don't like them, I'll just stretch them out. Until all three pieces are the exact same length. This is rope number one, that used to be the long piece. This is rope number two, that used to be the short piece, and there's rope number three. Oh, thank you! Nope, okay. I'll accept claps anyway. So guys, to finish up, if I ever want them to go back to their original lengths, all I have to do is just... to stop them, and we have our long piece right here, we have a medium piece and a small piece. Yeah. Alright, now we're all warmed up. We're all warmed up. So guys, you're a lovely crowd, you're a lovely crowd, I just wish I had a better act. So guys, I have a question, can anyone here solve a Rubik's Cube? Nope.
Only when it starts like that.
Ah, okay. Well, I tell you what, I can actually solve this cube. It's all it's taken me is 7 years and no girlfriend. I'm just, to start off with, I'm going to get this... be mixed up. And I'll let someone else mix this up as well. You don't have to get up on stage. I saw your hand go up pretty quickly. What was your name on that? I'm just going to call you Bob. Now,
what was
that? Oh, Google. Google. Nice to meet you, Google. Could you do me a favor? Just work. Mix up the cube. Make sure it's completely mixed up as much as you want. Now, with a Rubik's Cube, there's over 43 quintillion ways you can mix it up. That is more atoms in the galaxy. That is pretty much more atoms in the galaxy you can mix it up. And what do you feel like it's mixed up enough? It feels, yep, perfect. Thanks very much, man. I've learned how to solve this. My best time is 45 minutes. But for you, I'll do it a little bit quicker. If you have phones or if you have watches, if you have a stopwatch, anything you want, you can bring it up and you can time it. Not yet. Anyone else? So, ready? And I'll try, let's aim for 1 minute. Ready? And go. Watch. It's now solved.
I'll show you. There's one sort of Rubik's Cube. Now, I think you might have an idea of how I did that. The point that there's a second cube in there, I'll check. It's completely empty. See? You give me 10 of them.
Now, the more you
play with the cube, the better you get at solving it. You can actually keep track of... Do you mind if I start over again? I'll start over again. We'll try with this. I actually found out that the world record for solving a cube is 5 seconds. 5 seconds is pretty impressive. I can never do that. So I've got the cheating move. The cheating move is where I toss it in the air. And it sounds soft. I'll try that again, but twice as hard. I'm going to take the cube, I'm going to toss it behind my back, and when I catch it, it's going to be soft. Ready? From a mix up, one hand, behind the back, and it's completely soft. To finish up, I'm going to get someone else to mix this up, and I'll solve it with magic. I'll get someone else, you can be. Volunteer, you don't have to get up on the stage or the dance floor. Yeah, I'll let you do that. Could you mix it up? Oh, no, you're going to give it to someone else. Yeah, that's fine. Mix it up as much as you want. Every time you turn it, it's a different way. There's 43 continuing ways you can mix it up. And when you do it like this, mix it up enough, just come back and hand the cue back to me. Thank you very much, man. Thanks very much. I'll just stay there just for a moment and I'll hand you back the cue. Alright, ready?
Here we go.
You ready? Going in stuff. And it sounds soft. Now that would be an impressive trick if there wasn't a second cube in the bag.
Could you do me a favor?
Just come right here. Just come right over here on that piece of chewing gum. Make it work. Hold out your hand for me. Hold out your hand. And just place your hand on the top like this. When I click my fingers, the cube will be solved. You ready? It's now solved. Check. That would have been amazing. Actually, hold the cube like this. Hold the cube like this. I actually found a different solution to the Rubik's Cube. It looks like this. I know it doesn't look like much yet, but the idea was... Can I just take that back? The idea was that I was going to get these two Rubik's Cubes to match completely on one side. Now, better than one side would it be side number two, side number three, side number four, five, and then all six sides. I completely matched. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'll shake your hand. Give a round of applause. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I've got a few more acts for you guys. I just want to say a quick thank you for your applause. And if you didn't enjoy me, my name is Razi. But if you didn't enjoy me, my name is Dynamite. So, thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed this last bit. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a great night. Thank you.